Welcome to this presentation from the Wisconsin First Detector Network. This video was adapted from a Wisconsin First Detector Network training session. In this video, you'll hear Brian Hudelson from the Plant Disease Diagnostic Clinic talk about tar spot.
And we'll start off by talking about a disease called tar spot, which amongst disease names is quite descriptive. Plant pathologists are prone to using Latin names as part of the disease name, but this is one that is a descriptive name, and it's a fungal disease. And actually, there are two variants of the disease that you can potentially see here in the state. The one that's shown on the left is actually a native variation of the disease, and this is one that occurs on silver maple, and it is not super common, but I do see it on occasion. The name of the disease comes from the fact that with this particular variant, you see very large, tarry-looking spots that form on the maple leaves. They can start early in the season, but are most prominent towards the end of the growing season, right before the leaves are going to come off for the fall. And if you look at the center of these disease areas, you'll see what looks like a thumbprint. So you'll see ridges, and very, very reminiscent of someone who's basically put a blob of tar on a leaf and then pushed it down with their thumb. The variant that we're seeing that technically would be probably considered invasive, although quite frankly one might consider it biocontrol given the host, is the variant that occurs on Norway maple, which at this point I believe that's considered an invasive. That tree was introduced from Europe, and the fungus is European in origin as well, so it has come across with this particular host. It forms also these kind of tarry-like spots, but they tend to be slightly more diffuse, at least initially during the growing season, and then we'll fill in later on. Our major concern here is that with this new species of the tar spot organism here in Wisconsin, whether or not this might eventually jump to native species of maple, something like sugar maple. So one of the things we're requesting folks do is if you start to see these more diffuse looking tar spot symptoms on sugar maple, send in a sample to our clinic for identification. We'd like to get a sense of whether it's the native species or this newer one from Europe. And if you tag any of these sorts of symptoms, tag them as a invasive, or just say we're concerned that this is the new variant of tar spot, we'll do the diagnosis for you for free. And we're always constantly looking for either new pests that are coming into the state, new pathogens, or old pathogens that might be jumping to new species, and we're happy to do those sorts of diagnostics free of charge. And this is how you get a hold of me if you have any questions.
Thanks for watching this video from the Wisconsin First Detector Network. To learn more about our network or to access additional information about invasive species in Wisconsin, please visit our website or contact us.